Now that we understand the when of adaptive design, namely the points at which our UI breaks, let's talk about the what of adaptive design, specifically the techniques for what to fix. Let's think back to what we wanted to optimize our UIs for and what we can do. Filling the width of the screen can become problematic on wider devices. This might not optimize for balance and line length. There are a couple of approaches we can take to address this. Firstly, you can show additional content on the screen. Instead of just filling the extra space, we can instead show more content there. One way to do this is to reveal previously hidden UI elements. For example, you might use an off-screen navigation draw on smaller devices, but then pin it on-screen on larger devices. We might also divide the available space to show additional content. For example, showing a details page on the same screen as a list, rather than on a completely new screen. We also might reflow content on different size screens to better arrange it. In this example, we're reflowing a few things on the larger screen. Firstly, we switch from a single column of content to multiple columns to make better use of the available space. Secondly, we're not just rearranging these content cards, we're also adjusting their layouts to better fit with this new arrangement. Lastly, we tweak the app bar height when the space is available for a more balanced, branded appearance. We can also use this reflow technique in different orientations on the same device. In this example, a portrait layout places an image with a set aspect ratio above some text. Now, using the same layout in landscape would likely fill the entire screen with an image and push the text down below the fold. A better approach would be to reflow the content so that it's horizontally stacked instead of vertically, allowing you to see both the image and the text together. Notice that we're also reflowing the fab to a more appropriate position for this layout. If you don't have more content to show on screen, then you can expand the content up to a point and then introduce margins to constrain it from growing too wide. This works extremely well with the paper metaphor, where you can use a paper surface which has a maximum width to constrain the content. This technique can also work great if you have rich imagery such as a full bleed background which you can put behind the content and layer a surface on top of it. This can create an extremely immersive experience.